Hello LEGO fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a summer 2014 LEGO Star Wars set. This one comes with 616 parts. It is the Mos Eisley Cantina. Let's start off with a little spin of the cantina structure so you can just see its general size and scope. You can see it doesn't go very deep there. It's kind of just giving you a bit of the outside, like a rim, like you've just kind of peeled off one layer of the thing going around the outside. I really like this big old dome right here. That's actually a hinged piece, so that's able to open up if you want a little more light into the waiting room area there in the front. And this is supposed to be a door. It's just a sliding door that's gonna open like so, a little bit remotely. All of this though folds up. The whole thing just kind of contracts. So these booths right here actually will push back in to the whole thing. It's actually attached back here. You've got this tray, this trough with a big old bone in it. You use that to move in and out the furniture in those booths. And then once that's all in, you can fold this in, you can fold this in, you can fold this in, and it all becomes very, very small. I feel like this is great for storage for kids who are actually going to be able to play with this thing because it'll fit better onto a shelf. It won't take up as much space. Now, before I open the thing back up, I just want to point out a very nice little moisture vaporator on the back of this thing. I like that build. I think that looks pretty proper. Now let's go through the individual compartments. So we saw this entranceway here, or kind of in between entranceway. Move that out of the way. It folds all the way open. And you see down in there, you see what's up against the wall right there? Yeah, that's a droid detector. Maybe you see it better from this side. I really appreciate the inclusion of that bit right there. These booths actually look really good, fully contracted in like that. You know, it's a little bit more realistic having them up against the walls like that. I like the little lights up on the walls. And those look like pretty comfy chairs and pretty appropriate to the thing. But when you push all this out, when you actually extend it out, it just becomes easier to place your minifigs in there. You can do your little Han versus Greedo scene right there if you like. And you get to choose who shoots first. Here's the second section over here. Exactly the same size with the arch overhead, covers all the way over. And they kind of put together the dark tan and the tan to kind of follow each other, makes it look like you've got kind of bricks underneath of there, you know, like actual bricks put together to put this thing, not just the plastic Lego bricks. Just got some details here and a couple of decanters. This is the section I was really looking forward to though, the bar itself. I just have a lot of memory of what that looked like in the movie. It just, I guess they did a really nice job with the props on the set for this, on, you know, in the movie. Just had a lot of interesting things on it. They've brought together a bunch of interesting little assemblies here, different kinds of taps, and trying to make it look kind of alien. And you do have one little register over here with a sticker on it. The pistol is not hidden quite as well as it ought to be. I do appreciate this kind of metallic silver looking piece that's been bent around, the tubing piece that's been bent around. And I also appreciate that the drawers back here are made with the newer mold of the piece that holds all that in. Got a couple of little round tiles in there just to represent coinage, but these are the ones that'll actually hold the drawers in place. There's a different version of this where the drawers will just easily slide out, and I hate that version and I want to see that version go away. I got lucky here. I think they still have some of the old ones and some of the colors, but at least for light bluish gray, it seems like we're getting just the newer ones now, and that's a big improvement. So overall, they've just captured some small bits, almost like a modular build with representative sections that represent key pieces of the cantina instead of trying to model the whole thing. Set comes with a new version of the land speeder. This has a similar build to the 2010 version, but now you've got these stickers to represent the uncowled engine over here, sticker up on the top. But obviously the most important thing here is that they've gotten the color closer than ever to the original, to the real thing in the movie. I really appreciate that because that's just a huge improvement. And I know that generally folks who had older versions of sets will always prefer those older versions no matter how good the newer versions are objectively, but I can't see any way to hold on to the older designs as being better. This is, like I said, it's very close to the 2010 build, but that color scheme is just great. Ah, awesome. For folks who haven't seen these before, these are just a couple more of those tubes just bent around. They're not even connected to anything. There are no studs holding these in. They're just two of them stacked up on top of each other. They use a panel here, panel here, panel here. They just kind of clamp the things in. Interesting technique. This is a Lego version of a CGI version of a dewback in olive green here. Print all over the thing. And he's got a very long set of reins. It's actually a rubber piece, so it's very flexible. Also has a saddle with a nice mount. You can put a weapon on one side, you can put a weapon on the other side as well if you like. Got the little slats coming down. Now, the whole saddle bit is intended to be removed if you would like, if you don't want this look. See, it's just exposed studs right there, and they do give you these rounded pieces to put on top. So if you don't want them to have a saddle at all, well, then you get your wild dewback, and he does have a mouth that can be opened like so. It has teeth in there. Those are actually printed a different color. They kind of make the bottom of the mouthpiece look like a tongue in there, so that works out pretty well. But other than the mouth, there's no articulation to this thing. It's otherwise just basically one big statue. I think it looks good though for what it is, especially when you mount it up with a sand trooper. Yeah, not too bad. So minifigs then. Here's the first batch of them. Luke, Ben, Han, Greedo, and a sand trooper, obviously. Sand troopers were my favorite version of the stormtroopers back in the day. I think they still are to this day. This version of Greedo is based on a base color of medium azure, and the head there is actually molded with two different plastics. Yep, you got the sand green and you got the dark blue, and it actually has some print. It's really tough to see, even looking at it close with the naked eye, it's kind of tough to see, but they did put some little highlights in his eyes with a lighter color that just makes him look more bug-like and realistic, I would say. According to LEGO officially, all of these are new configurations of minifigs except for Han. All of them are new for this season. I like the pack that they put on the back of the sand trooper there. And you can see a little bit more of the detail of Greedo's head there. And you can see the prints on the backs of these torsos. Also start to see the face, the secondary face coming out from underneath Han's hair there. That's a little bit unfortunate. Don't have a second face on the back of Ben, but you do have a different one for Luke. There's a look from the front, so you can see them all without any hair, and especially now you can see the sand trooper's armor. Also the fact that he has the angry clone face, and a little bit better look at Greedo. And there's a better look at those two from behind. And then there are these guys, Biff band members. And I am certain that a lot of folks out there will buy two of this set in order to be able to put together a full band. Not enough there, but it's nice that they did give us an assortment of them, so you can really just imagine the music playing in the background. Very nicely done, I would say, with these head molds, and also with the nice light color for the hands. Goes together very well. Yeah, those are proper. Those are definitely proper. I definitely do recommend that folks who want to have a full band, go ahead and just get two of the set. No shame in it, even if you're just looking to get more of these guys to fill out a collection for your own diorama. You still get all the other stuff with your second Cantina set as well. And I think that's gonna work out quite nicely for you. This is a very nice little set. You know, it captures the scene decently well. Personally, I would have made a different choice of minifigs to make it feel even more grungy and dingy. I definitely like the new color scheme for the land speeder. There really isn't anything here that I dislike in this set. I just would have liked to get more of everything. More different minifigs, more booths, more bar. I suppose that's what customization is for though, huh? Well anyway, you've now heard my thoughts about this one. Please feel free to let your thoughts be heard. Go ahead and post up a comment. Let me know whether you like this set or dislike it, and why. Hit thumbs down on the video if you didn't like the video. Thumbs up on the video if you did like the video. Regardless of what you think about the set. As always, you can follow my blog at JANGBRiCKS.com for all of my latest updates and often to see things before they're published on YouTube, and also to see things that are never going to be published on YouTube because they're not going to be made into videos. Whatever you do, don't go away for long because I've got more videos on the way. Talk to you again soon.